In this year, at national level, 7 of our cadets participated in various camps and competitions and brought laurels to our college. Cadet Siddharth Sriram from Economics Department was number one best cadet representing Tamil Nadu, Andaman and Puducherry Directorate in Republic Day competition. Cadet Vignesh from Sociology Department representing Tamil Nadu in Firing and Obstacles team in National Talsani competition held at New Delhi. Cadet John Felix from the Department of History was selected to attend Advanced Mountaineering Camp held at Jammu and Kashmir. Cadet K. Arun from the Department of Mathematics was one of the best cadets in representing Tamil Nadu, Andaman and Puducherry Directorate in Para-Jumping course at Army Airborne Training School. He cleared successfully all the 5 jumps from the aircraft. Cadet Infant Kamal Raju from the Department of Mathematics and Cadet Vishal from the Department of Physics was selected to attend SSB screening capsule held at Officers Training Academy, Kamti, and he was recommended by the committee to join different research and development organization. 15 cadets from our college were selected for Army Attachment Camp held at Secunderabad. They went rigorous training for 2 weeks with 8th Battalion of Dogra Regiment. Cadet A. Akash Raja from Zoology Department represented Tamil Nadu, Andaman and Puducherry Directorate in National Level Sports Camp held at New Delhi. Apart from regular camps and competitions, the cadets involved themselves in social service activity and campaign. Around 150 cadets from our college participated in the Rally Against Human Rights Violation. As an observation visit, all the cadets visited Officers Training Academy, Chennai and learned about the lifestyle of an officer cadet. It was a morale booster for all the cadets. Loyola NCC Army Wing and Navy Wing organized a UGC-sponsored 2-day workshop. Around 250 cadets was benefited by this program.
Loyola NCC Navy has achieved really remarkable things in this academic year also. In addition to regular parade and then other training activities, we have conducted and participated many social awareness activities based on the themes child labor, human rights, drug abuse, and then AIDS awareness, and as per the PM's recommendations, that Swachh Bharat also we have participated, and we just made awareness to the public, and it was covered by many dailies and then news channels. AK Saravanan of Sociology Department has won gold in the All India Firing Competition, which was really a greatest achievement for the past 5 years. This is the first kind from Loyola. Michael Amalraj of Mathematics Department and Raghadeepan of Tamil Department, they represented Tamil Nadu team, and they won gold in both drill and then cultural competitions. John Gideon of Mathematics Department badged BC Silver in IGC, and Jnana Prakasam participated in RDC selection camps where he gave a very tight situation to the selectors to reject him. MP Varun of BCA and John Gideon again of Mathematics Department, they participated in Advanced Leadership Camp in Trichendur. Cadet Dilip of Physics Department, he is the one who participated in almost all ship visit camp conducted by 1TN Naval Unit. Also, he represented Tamil Nadu Directorate and participated in the All India Sailing Competition and stood 4th place out of 17 contestants. In addition to that, he made a submarine visit and in ship attachment camps with INS Rajput and also with ICGS Sarang, Indian Coast Guard.
The Loyola Health Center offers clinical and medical assistance to the students and the staff members of the Loyola College 10:30 to 6:30 p.m. The medical officer is available at the within the college premises from 10:30 to 3:30 p.m. To provide optimum healthcare facilities, the Loyola Jesuit management has taken care of the full expenditure and the clinical and the pharmaceutical needs. The academic year 2014 and 15 has seen significant strides in the history of Loyola Health Center. With the use of advanced techniques like the 12-lead ECG, the nebulization techniques, the IV fluid resuscitation techniques, psychiatric counseling, hypertensive, diabetic and cholesterol screening, the health center has attained greater heights.
This academic year, there are 110 disabled students benefiting out of the center. With the help of Help the Blind Foundation, we are sponsoring 55 students by paying hostel and mess fees. In collaboration with the Satya Sai organization volunteers, we arrange for strides during the internal examinations. This academic year, our students have brought laurels to our college by winning competitions held in Netrodaya, MIT, Rotaract Club of Drishti, and various other organizations for the differently abled. On October 8, 2014, we observed a white hail day. Mrs. Maggie from NIVH motivated the students on the need of using the cane. A seminar on employment opportunities for visually challenged was held on 10th December 2014. Mr. Alagiya Perumal and Ajith Thomas were the guest speakers of the day. On 27th February, a UGC-sponsored workshop on soft skills for the differently abled was held at the MRF Hall. The trainees were from World Vision and they interacted with the students. An intercollegiate cultural and sports meet was held on 4th March. Students from various institutions showcased their talents and made it a memorable day. An intercollegiate sports and cultural meet was held on 4th March 2015. Students from various colleges showcased their talents and made it a memorable event.
Loyola Hostel is a melting pot of diverse culture. Students from Northeast, Bihar, Jharkhand, Orissa, Maharashtra, Karnataka and Kerala make this hostel a vibrant unit of Loyola College. The objective of the Jesuit education is twofold. Primarily, we aim at training our men to be the leaders in all walks of life, to serve the fellow men in truth, love and justice. And secondarily, we foster in an atmosphere of intellectual vigor and moral rectitude in which our students find fulfillment and achieve greatness. Of all the activities of this year, I recollect two of them. The first one is in winter, in last December before Christmas, our students gathered together for a new noble cause. They visited all the railway stations from Tambaram to Beach and distributed more than 200 blankets to all the homeless platform dwellers. This is an expression of expressing our solidarity to the suffering mass. And another one, there are hostelers involved in ministry in imparting knowledge to the slum children around Loyola College area. Organized by our students in last January, around 100 children came here and participated in a sports and cultural activities. In a way, our vision is not only to enable them excel in academics, but also to sensitize them on social issues and to form them as change makers in transforming the quality of life of people who are deprived of and marginalized.
Loyola Women's Hostel is a confluence of students from four prestigious institutions in this campus. We have 495 energetic, resourceful young women from 22 different states from India and four international students from Japan, US, Sharjah and Singapore, making it uniquely global. LWH is a canvas of multicultural aura. Various committees are formed in the hostel, such as liturgy, cultural, sports, magazine, decoration, discipline, etc., to involve the students in the hostel administration and to hold responsibilities. Need-based talks were arranged, such as healthy life, life is beautiful, prevention of cancer, etc. A picnic for the student representatives were arranged to Pondicherry. It was a joyful experience for the students and it helped them to deepen their relationship among themselves. During the season of Christmas, students contributed ₹25,000 to help the young destitute women at Ambattur. During the season of Lent, a retreat was organized by Reverend Father Jerry S.J. for all the Catholic students of the hostel. It was an invitation for all the students to become a better persons and thus to create a better society.
Friends, I'm happy to share with you the activities of Loyola Alumni Association. We had our annual Alumni Day on the 2nd of October. We had Ms. Bino, IAS officer, visually handicapped student. We greeted her, we felicitated her. We had Mr. Jay Shankar, the income tax commissioner, as the guest of honor. And we had one Mr. Ramasubramaniam, the oldest person, who shared his reflections. We also had our Christmas get-together for the first time of the executive committee members with their families. They were 150 in number. We were very much encouraged. On the Alumni Day, we had 1,400 members who participated in this, especially younger members from 2000 year onwards. We also paid our homage to Mr. Kothari, the past president of the Alumni Association for 10 years. We record his yeoman service to the Alumni Association. We had the Jerome D'Souza Endowment Lecture given by Justice Cyriac Joseph on how secular India is. We also had the 13th logo meeting at Kodaikanal on the 2nd, 3rd and 4th of January, in which the hostel project explained by Father Rector was accepted by the logo committee.
Training and Placement Office of Loyola had a very good response from the corporate world for the placement of students for the outgoing batch 2015. Variety of roles were given to the Loyolites from a wide spectrum of sectors across, like investment management companies, share trading, financial analysis, teaching, telecom, business processing, web designing, and many more. This year, the Training and Placement Office conducted special training on verbal ability and quantitative ability. Mock tests and mock interviews were also conducted by professional trainers. About 32 companies have visited our campus, and many more have booked their dates for the forthcoming weeks. About 194 students have been placed through campus recruitment, and 10 students have been placed abroad. The minimum salary package being 15,000 to 20,000, and the maximum being 1 lakh per month, has been offered by the institutions who had come down for the campus recruitment. This year, the management, together with the Placement and Training Office of Loyola College, have taken a new initiative of inviting the sister concern, Loyola College Vetavalam, students for the placement in our campus. And we were successful in recruiting one student, Flavi Priya, in RBS. We also hope to continue the same in future.
Loyola College Teaching Staff Association was formally inaugurated by a simple, honest and renowned justice, Mr. K. Chandru, retired judge, High Court of Madras. In his inaugural address, he stressed the need for serving the people outside the college also. We had triple celebrations, namely Christmas, New Year and Pongal in the month of January. Reverend Father Thisai Jerry, a well-known musician and a priest, felicitated on the occasion. He emphasized the importance of spirituality in everyone's life. We had a memorable one-day picnic on the Republic Day. Many members joyfully participated and enjoyed the picnic. This year, 10 of our professors are retiring. We fondly remember, and with gratitude, we thank every one of them for their dedicated service to the association and to the college. I finally thank all the members for their fullest cooperation to the association.
2-7-2015 அன்று சங்கத்தின் 32வது ஆண்டு விழாவும் திருவாளர் ஏ ஜேம்ஸ் அருள்ராயன் அவர்களுக்கு பணி நிறைவு பாராட்டு விழாவும் இணைந்தே நடத்தப்பட்டது. இந்த விழாவில் அருட்தந்தையர்கள், அதிபர், செயலர் மற்றும் முதல்வர் அனைவரும் விழா நாயகரை வாழ்த்தி பேசினார்கள். சங்கத்தின் சார்பில் திருவாளர் ஜேம்ஸ் அருள்ராயன் அவர்களுக்கு பொன்னாடை போர்த்தி மாலை அணிவித்து 1 பவுன் மோதிரம் பரிசாக வழங்கப்பட்டது. நிர்வாகத்தின் சார்பில் ₹10,000, முன்னாள் மாணவர் சங்கத்தின் சார்பில் ₹5,000 கொடுத்து பெருமைப்படுத்தினார்கள். 10-12-2015 அன்று சங்கத்தின் சார்பில் கிறிஸ்து பிறப்பு விழா ஜேடி அரங்கத்தில் நடைபெற்றது. கிறிஸ்து பிறப்பு நற்செய்தியை அருட்தந்தை ஜேக்கப் சேசா அவர்கள் வழங்கினார்கள். கிறிஸ்து பிறப்பு விழாவை முன்னிட்டு வருடந்தோறும் அனாதை இல்லம், சிறுவர் இல்லம் சென்று உதவி செய்து வருகிறோம். 18-12-2014 வியாழன் அன்று மனசு HIV எய்ட்ஸ் நோயினால் பாதிக்கப்பட்டவர்களை சந்தித்து உறுப்பினர்கள் வழங்கிய கருணைத் தொகை ₹27,450 கொடுத்து கேக் வெட்டி பகிர்ந்து கொண்டாடினோம். 10-1-2015 சனிக்கிழமை ஒரு நாள் உல்லாச பயணமாக ஏற்காடு சென்று வந்தோம். ஒரு நாள் உல்லாச பயணத்திற்கு அருட்தந்தை செயலர் அவர்கள் ₹40,000 கொடுத்து உதவினார்கள்.
his High Commissioner of South Africa, New Delhi, for his valuable presence today at the 90th College Day function. The team of people worked in bringing out this College Day report in visual format deserves a round of applause as a token of our appreciation. Let us give them a big round of applause. I would like to especially thank Professor Suresh Paul and Professor Chinnappan and Mr. Adaikala Raj for their wonderful work with unstinting support for a band of students of visual communication. It was their handiwork. They have done a great job. I express my words of appreciation and thanks to the IQAC of Loyola College for its wonderful work and meticulous documentation. I thank Dr. Xavier Mahime Raj, IQAC coordinator, in a special way for his role in bringing out this College Day report in AV format. Kudos to the team. I am extremely fortunate to have an inspiring and wonderful band of dedicated officials, staff members, and non-teaching staff to share my responsibility during this fulfilling academic year. They stood by me and helped me in every possible way. I profusely thank each one of them. Let your light shine is the motto of Loyola College. We, as partners of this temple of learning, we are grateful to our forefathers, all the former professors, for their dedicated service that has brought the new status to our college, College of Excellence. We also gratefully remember our alumni who are our ambassadors. They have contributed their might to build our nation and the world. And my dear students, following their footsteps, let us accept the challenge to build our nation and contribute our might through this higher education through in Loyola College. Let us build this nation as a wonderful country. May God bless you. Thank you, one and all. And now I request His Excellency F.K. Morule, High Commissioner of South Africa in our country, for his address to us.
Thank you very much. The college principal and the rector, the leadership of Loyola College, jubilarians, the staff members that are retiring, parents, students, ladies and gentlemen, all protocol observed. I am delighted to have been invited to this august event to participate in the 90th College Day celebrations at this prestigious college. Education is a product of the process of socialization and can be progressive and inculcate the ideals of human dignity, racial and gender equality, human rights, tolerance of different worldviews, and respect for unity in diversity. Education can enlighten society against discrimination and prejudice, for it encourages critical thinking and sheds scientific light on superstition, myths, and stereotypes. It serves as a stepladder to progress from subhuman conditions into a qualitative and productive life for the betterment of humanity. Former President of South Africa, Dr. Nelson Mandela, once said, and I quote, education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world. End of quotation. Loyola College brought this into life when it stated clearly in its mission statement that the college seeks to shape students into agents of change. The college does this through provision of university education and training to young men and women to be leaders and to serve their society with justice, truth, and love. Another great son of the soil, Mahatma Gandhi Ji, said, and I quote, "Education links the children, whether of the cities or the villages, to all that is best and lasting in India." End of quotation. And further said, I quote, "Education should be the all-round drawing out the best in the child, body, mind, and spirit." End of quotation. It is through education and training that the youth is empowered to make informed career choices and is actively directed towards becoming central to the envisaged skills and capable workforce that supports an inclusive growth path for India, a vibrant democracy, and a flourishing economy. Education is a means to building an inclusive society and providing opportunities for all children to realize their full potential. Loyola College is doing the most impeccable work in this regard through providing education to the poor, economically isolated, unemployable, and those suffering from the burden of inequality. Distinguished guests, education is the single most important intervention that can radically address the socio-economic transformation. Poverty, inequality, and unemployment can only be addressed with an educated, well-trained, and skilled workforce. It is very humbling to see Loyola College engaged in the process of ensuring access to post-school opportunities, overcoming inequalities in education and training, and striving for high levels of excellence and innovation for the most needy. Again, and I quote Nelson Mandela G when he said, and I quote, "A good head and a good heart are always a formidable combination. But when you add to that a literate tongue or pen, then you have something very special." End of quotation. Ladies and gentlemen, a much deserved recognition and appreciation must be directed towards the college principal, the rector, the academic and the support staff for their sacrifices, patience, hard work, and perseverance in molding these young minds into invaluable assets and upright members of society. Now to the retirees, we wish you a special moment in your retirement. But from experience, because my mother also is a retired teacher, I know that a teacher never retires. You'll always contribute towards the development of your communities. Because teaching is in your DNA. A special word also goes to the parents in playing their supportive role to their children. Ladies and gentlemen, there is correlation between the level of socioeconomic development and the extent and level of literacy, functional literacy, skills development, the number of graduates and postgraduates the number of professionals in any country. This makes the per capita income on education a very significant factor in societal development. This year, 2015, being the deadline to achieve the Millennium Development Goals, much has been achieved, and yet much still needs to be done in achieving the target around education, particularly in the developing countries. It is for this reason that I would like to challenge each and every student in this college to strive for excellence, knowledge, and development. The hopes of your families, your communities, and your countries are vested in you. Therefore, it is imperative that you draw inspiration from Mahatma Gandhi G and Nelson Mandela G, who heeded the call when humankind needed leaders who will stand for justice, truth, democracy, leadership, and human rights. Their unquestionable devotion to the struggle for the liberation of the oppressed societies has been one of the utmost sacrifices of the modern world. Currently, the world is going through a number of challenges: climate change, the effects of the global financial and economic crisis, the food crisis, extreme poverty and inequality, water scarcity, energy security, migration, population growth, and demographic shifts, urbanization and health pandemics, and infectious diseases. The world is looking up to you to utilize your skills, knowledge, and excellence you have accumulated at Loyola College in promoting research in environmental sciences, economics, developmental studies, health sciences, etc., etc. Mahatma Gandhi G said, and I quote, "Be the change that you wish to see in the world," end of quotation. As the next generation that will inherit this country and the world, the time has come for you to shine, take the baton from the great statesmen, and work tirelessly at moving your country and the world towards uplifting the most needy in society in terms of socioeconomic development, the eradication of poverty and inequality, underdevelopment, malnutrition, and illiteracy. Do not forget that in doing so, you also contribute towards finding solutions to the challenges currently being experienced in the world. Furthermore, you will also be plowing back to your communities. Remember that your generation will be judged by how it responded to the call of humankind in a time of need. Rise up to the occasion and be the great generation that the world currently requires. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir, for honoring jubilarians and retiring staff. Next comes Loyola Award. Loyola Award was introduced in 2014, and the award was given to alumni of our college. Last year, the first Loyola Award was given to Mr. Sahayam IAS for his tremendous work for the society. Today, a journalist is going to receive the second Loyola Award. So I stand here to invite a man with compassionate heart and head of all the institutions in the campus of Loyola College, Reverend Father Jayapathy Francis of the Society of Jesus, the rector of Loyola campus, to present the citation.
It is appropriate, Your Excellency F.K. Murule, that we present this Loyola Award in your presence. In 1979, when I received my first passport, it carried a phrase which said, valid for all countries except South Africa. That was the way India registered its disapproval in strongest terms to the apartheid that was being imposed upon vast number of our fellow men and women. Your soil was where the last successful phase of our freedom struggle sprouted in the inspiration and the training it provided to our father of the nation, Mahatma Gandhi. So it is with great sense of appropriateness that I present the Loyola Award 2015. What is Loyola Award? If you have your calendar and your books, you would see that the motto of Loyola College is to form women and men for and with others. We find alumnus year after year who have somehow appropriated this vision and mission in their lives and have consistently stood by this value of being man or woman for and with others. This year's award is being presented to Mr. Palagumi Sainath. Palagumi Sainath is an alumnus of Loyola College. After his undergraduate years in Loyola, he obtained a master's degree in history from JNU Delhi. He started his career as a journalist and photojournalist in 1980, focusing on social problems, rural affairs, poverty, and the aftermath of globalization in India. He was hailed by Amartya Sen, the Nobel laureate, as a great exponent of the true causes of famine and hunger. On a Times of India fellowship, he toured 10 poorest districts of 5 states, which resulted in 84 newspaper published articles, which formed major part of this non-fiction bestseller, Everybody Loves a Good Drought. He had a long stint as a developmental journalist, serving the United News of India, Blitz, and the Hindu. He was always focused on the poor, the rural poor. His writing ushered in many a change, including the revamping of the drought management programs in Tamil Nadu, establishing Agricultural Commission in Andhra Pradesh, developing a policy on indigenous medical systems in Malkangiri in Orissa, and strengthening the tribal development program in Madhya Pradesh. He has received a number of awards, including the prestigious Ramo Magsaysay Award in 2007. The University of Alberta conferred on him the degree of Doctor of Literature in 2011. Joe Maulins, a Canadian documentary filmmaker, made a film on Sainath titled A Tribe of His Own. His heart beats in sync with the agrarian poor in India. His pen writes on behalf of the hunger-stricken, and his camera clicks their plight. Loyola takes pride in conferring the Loyola Award 2015 on Palagumi Sainath, a true crusader of agrarian workers of India. இன்று லோயோலா தன் மகன் சாண்டோன் என கேட்ட தாய், ஐ ரிக்வெஸ்ட் யுவர் எக்ஸலன்சி டு ரிசீவ் த சைட்டேஷன் ஆன் பிஹாஃப் ஆஃப் சாய்நாத் ஹூ வில் கம் டு லோயோலா இன் ஜூலை டு ரிசீவ் இட் பர்சனலி.
Thank you, Father. Graciousness, acceptance is an art which most never bother to cultivate. We think that we have to learn how to give, but we forget about accepting things, which can be much harder than giving. And a change can be beautiful when we are brave enough to evolve with it. With these few words, I would like to invite Reverend Father Albert William, the mastermind of change on this ever-evolving campus, the secretary and the correspondent of Loyola College, to express his joy and felicitate the gathering.
His Excellency F.K. Moral, is High Commissioner of South Africa, New Delhi, Father Rector, Father Principal, Father Controller of Examination, Deputy Principal, Vice Principal, respected professors who are retiring this year. After so many years of committed service to Loyola College, professors, alumni, students, ladies and gentlemen, a very good evening to everyone. Good evening. Yesterday evening, at 5 o'clock, I started my journey from Kuwait via Muscat and reached Loyola today at 7:30 in the morning after attending an international conference at Kuwait University. At Kuwait University, a professor made me a comment saying, there is a difference between a Loyola student and a Kuwait University student in attitude. I asked him, what difference? Then he replied, Loyola student's attitude is, a Loyola student will say, if someone can do it, I can do it. If someone can do it, I can do it. If nobody can do it, I must do it. I must do it. But he said, the Kuwait student's attitude is, the Kuwait student will say, if somebody can do it, let him do it. Let him do it. If nobody can do it, Allah, how can I do it? This is how a loyalite is always unique, extraordinary, and special from any other college student. Hence, Loyola College Day is a memorable moment to all the staff and students. Today is a day of hope, for we are here to strengthen each other, that as students, we have acquired essential knowledge and character to survive in the competitive world. And as educator, we have imparted education values to shape the future. Also, it is a rare privilege given to me to greet these eminent professors who have served this institution with dedication and retiring this academic year. An institution is what it is based on the quality of the professors who work in it. Thanks in million to the dedication of the professors and the non-teaching staff. All these persons who are retiring this year have been pillars of strength and have helped to come up to the level of College of Excellence in India. While I greet you today, I pray the Lord Almighty to keep you in good health for many more years and take care of you as he has done all these years.
என்ன உங்களுக்கு சொல்ல விரும்புகிறேன், 365 நாளும் ஒரே ஒருவர் இந்த கேம்பஸில் காலையில் இருந்து சாயந்தரம் வர 365 நாள் லீவே எடுக்காமல் ஒரு மனுஷன் வேலை செய்யும், அது யார் சொல்ல முடியுமா? யார் தெரியுமா ரிட்டையர் ஆகிறாருன்றைக்கு அவர் யார்? கண்ணி இப்போ கொஞ்சம் எழுந்திருக்கிறீங்களா? இந்த மனுஷன் தான் 365 நாளும். ஐயா, உங்களை கடவுள் நல்லா ஆசிர்வதிக்கணும், நீடிய ஆயுள் கொடுக்கணும். உங்களோட மத்த எல்லாருக்கும் சேர்ந்து Let us give a thundering applause for all the retiring professors. ரொம்ப நன்றி ஐயா.
And also for me, it is a retirement of sorts as well. Though I retired in the eyes of the government 2 years ago, I have been acting both in teaching and in administration. Now it's time to bid bye to this great institution, at least for the time being. I am laying down my office as a secretary of the college, which I held for the past 3 years. It was only befitting that I look back the past years of my association with the Loyola College. I enjoyed my teaching career. As a secretary of the college, I had an opportunity to spread my wings beyond the narrow confines of one department to which I belonged. I am always happy to have played my role in every little possible way in all our efforts to make Loyola grow in heights. Permit me to go back in memory lane for 2 minutes. I thank the management of Loyola College for the unstinted cooperation I received from the rectors, principals, the campus treasurer, and the Jesuit fathers. It was a joy working with the staff, both teaching and non-teaching staff of Loyola College. I could rely on their unconditional support at any time. I thank them all from the bottom of my heart. I have been able to improve the infrastructure to some extent, starting from extending this stage to providing the needed computers of the departments. I enjoyed doing this work. Perhaps the biggest achievement of all was that we are able to get the approval of the teaching staff. Believe me, it is not that easy to get it from the government. There were many sleepless nights, hopeless days, and ultimately, to our joy and relief, we got the post sanction. I am grateful to God for using me as his instrument to achieve this. Another thing that gave me immense satisfaction was the improvement of the salary of both management teaching and non-teaching staff. In the past 3 years, we have been able to increase the salary substantially, moving towards the UGC scale. Thanks to the verdict of the High Court on the fee structure case, we were in a comfortable position economically to share this with the staff. The management has been open to increasing the salary. That I'm always happy to be part of this sort to this. At this time, I would like to thank the non-teaching staff, ready to be of service at any time of the day or night. I enjoyed working with the non-teaching staff, and I owe a debt of gratitude
for what they have been to me the last 3 years. Let us give a clap for all the non-teaching staff. I will definitely miss their company in the days to come. I thank the management for trusting me with this famous institution, the rector for his guidance, the principal for his cooperation with me, and the campus treasurer for his support. And my dear students, before I go back to my seat, I want to tell you on this special day that you have every reason to feel proud of yourself. What makes you great is that you are a loyalite, which means you are on an edge over anyone in the job market competing with you. Loyola has made you to survive in the top ranks. You have been groomed well in knowledge and values. What would remember when we are gone from here are those memorable moments we have had with our teachers and friends in the classrooms. It is true that you can take a man out of Loyola College, but not Loyola out of the man. Certainly, in the days to come, I will cherish the time I had spent at Loyola with my student. Finally, my dear student, the future is what you make of it. So, dream of a great future for you and for the nation. உன்னால் வளர்ந்தது உலகம் என்று வரலாறு சொல்லும் உன்னால் வளர்ந்தது உலகம் என்று வரலாறு சொல்லும் உன்னை வளர்த்தது லோயலா என்று நீ சொல் உன்னை வளர்த்தது லோயலா என்று நீ சொல் வீசட்டும் உன் ஒளி ஒளிரட்டும் வான்வெளி ஆல் தி பெஸ்ட் மே காட் பிளஸ் யூ தேங்க் யூ
Thank you, Father. We move on further with the evening's proceedings, the much awaited session where we recognize the commitment of our students, staff in actualizing the goals of our Jesuit corporate policy of expansion, inclusion, and excellence. The greatest thing is at any moment to be willing to give up who we are in order to become all that we can become. Now let me invite Dr. Professor S. Alphonse Raj, the Vice Principal, to present the list of our meritorious students.
May I invite Father Rector and Father Secretary to present these prizes to the prize winners. Foundation Studies, Reverend Father Leo Correa SJ Prize, Bala Vikram S. Foundation Studies, Reverend Dr. Michael Urudem SJ Prize, Father Machoda Award, Yusuf Sharif. Foundation Studies, Reverend Dr. Michael Urudem SJ Prize, Deepak SPM. Beginners French, Mrs. C. Kanthamma Medal, Samir Eka. General English, Father Lay Medal, Nova Francis Jones. Hindi 1, Sri R.K. Jave Medal, Yash Gupta. Sanskrit, Mr. Ramachandra Shastri Prize, and also BA History, Tamil Nadu Through Ages, Manikyavasa Memorial Prize, both go to George Joseph. BAC Advanced Zoology, Navanita Krishnan G. BAC Advanced Zoology, Dr. Shivaraman Medal, Suman Kumar Ganin. BAC Chemistry, Dr. E.V. Srinivasan Medal, Carlson Alexander. BSc Chemistry 2, Mr. Sundaram Ramayya Prize, Prakash JD. BCA Computer Applications first rank and also Advanced French, Ms. Vasanta Subramanian Medal. Both medals go to Muhammad Jafar Sadiq. BSc Computer Science first rank, Tulasidharan. BSc Mathematics, M. Sundaram Iyer Memorial Medal and Professor M. R. Adaikalasamy Medal, both go to, and also BSc Mathematics first rank for the Inchakad Medal. Three medals go to Saravanan S. Dr. Bharati Award to Muhammad Samsudin for the Inchakul SJ Medal and Dhabra Rama Shastri Medal to Jithin Thomas Matthew. BSc Plant Biology and Biotechnology, Part 3, first rank, Arun KB. BSc Statistics, Part 3, rank 1, Kaushik Ganesh. Visual Communication for the Inchakul SJ Medal to Vishal Khanna. BBA first rank goes to Siddharth B. BCom first rank, Hariharan B. BCom Corporate Secretaryship first rank, Akash Dilip Kumar Mehta. BA Economic Krishnaya Prize to Karthik L. BA English first rank and also Beginner's French first rank goes to Jobin George. BA French Literature and also for the lay medal go to Jean-Francois Salomon. Ganesh A. Swaminathan Iyer Prize go to Mahendranath S. BA Sociology Prabhu Ganesan Medal go to Arvind P. BA Tamil Part 3 first rank medal goes to Saravanan S. BSc Advanced Zoology and Biotechnology first rank, Mr. Irudayanesan Memorial Medal and K.S. Joseph Simon Memorial Medal both go to Kevin J. BSc Chemistry first rank, Raja Sir Annamalai Chettiar Medal go to Sujit Kumar D. BCA first rank goes to Pun Clinton Jose. BSc Computer Science first rank goes to Balaji D. BSc Mathematics first rank, that is K.S. Joseph Simon Memorial Medal and also Hansraj Jivandas Prize go to Amal Bosco J of Mathematics Department. BSc Physics first rank, Father Hono Medal goes to Aman Chokshi. BSc Plant Biology and Biotechnology, three prizes, Richie Wilson Medal, Mr. T.A. Venkateshwaran Prize, R.R. Kevin Wilson Medal go to Nikhil P.T. BSc Statistics Part 3 for the Bertram Medal goes to Girish Garg. Dr. P. Chandrasekhar Medal for Catholic students from Statistics go to Maria Antoine Vivek. BSc Visual Communication for the Inchakul SJ Medal goes to Shyam S. BSc Visual Communication for the Inchakul SJ Medal goes to Sharada S. Business Administration first rank goes to Deepak Jain M. BCom first rank, Mr. Ramarao Medal goes to Magesh V. BCom Commerce Human Resource Management, the topper gets the prize, Reverend Dr. Peter Xavier SJ Medal to Divyesh Doshi. BCom Corporate Secretary first rank secured by Pradeep S. BA Economics first rank, T.P. Norna Medal goes to Gopi Krishna K.R. BA Economics, Fiscal Economics, Mr. A. Alexander IPS Medal goes to Meyyappan Kumaran S. BA English Literature first rank, Ananta Ramakrishnan Medal goes to Amal George. BA French Literature Part 3 first rank secured by Blanchard Fernand Murray. BA History First Rank Srimati Rupani Amal Medal goes to Anish Kumar Sess. BA Sociology First Rank Ms. Aburvam Rajan Memorial Prize goes to Manoj Aravind IAC. BA Tamil Literature First Rank Mangalam Lakshmi Medal goes to Dileeban T. MSc Biotechnology First Prize TA Venkateshwaran Prize 2 goes to Nimi Vinci. MSc Chemistry First Rank 3 prizes go to Liju R. Mary Apollon Memorial Medal, Father L. Ednapalli Medal, Reverend Dr. B. Jairaj S.J. Medal. MSc Food Chemistry Food Processing First Rank secured by Deepthi Suganya. MSc Mathematics First Rank Krishnasamy Memorial Medal and also Dr. R. Bharati Award go to Ansi Antonita. Teresa T. gets 2 prizes for securing the first rank in MSc Medical Lab Technology and she also gets Dr. P. Venkatesan Medal. MSc Physics First Rank goes to Arvind K. and he gets Father Integral S.J. Medal too. MSc Physics Second Rank Father Integral S.J. Medal goes to Parthiban K. MSc Statistics First Rank Srimati Sri Subramanian Prize First goes to Shivaprakash S. MSc Statistics, Dr. B. Chandrasekhar Medal for Catholic Student goes to Ambativ Varun Kumar. MSCA First Rank was secured by Julian A. MSc Computer Science First Rank secured by Harihara Krishnan R. L.C. Rani of MSc Zoology gets 4 medals and prizes for the Integral S.J. Medal, Dr. K. Raghunath Rao Medal, Zoology Department Golden Jubilee Medal and Reverend Dr. S. Xavier Alphon S.J. Medal. MSc Visual Communication First Rank secured by Leo Johnson. MA Applied History First Rank secured by Ashwini Barla. MCOM First Rank Father Integral S.J. Medal goes to Rinku Jose. MA Economics First Rank Professor S. David Michael Memorial Medal goes to Neha Ramakrishnan. MA English First Rank, AX George and Clarama George Medal goes to Pavan Kumar R. MA Media Arts First Rank secured by Rajesh M. MSc Medical Sociology First Rank secured by Amulya Tete. MA Philosophy First Rank secured by Sagili Karunakar. MA Philosophy First Rank also secured by Almeida Vivian Stanislaus.